Hi students, welcome back to the biology online YouTube classes. In previous video we discussed about cell, plant cell as well as animal cell. We saw the diagram, we saw the labeling of both plant cell and animal cell. Then we started discussing each components present in the cell. Here we are going to discuss in general in plant cell and animal cell. At the same time, while we are discussing the components, I am going to tell you the difference between plant cell and animal cell. In this video, let us discuss about cytoplasm and its organelles. Cytoplasm, it is the fluid gel-like liquid present inside the plasma membrane, and plasma membrane is the outermost covering of the plant cell because it survives. And outside the plasma membrane, plant cell have cell wall, but in animal cell, cell wall is absent. So in animal cell, plasma membrane is the outermost covering. Cytoplasm is thick gel-like fluid that found in both plant cell as well as animal cell. Cytoplasm is present in both plant cell as well as animal cell. The constituent parts of cytoplasm are cytosol, cell organelles, and cytoplasmic inclusions. Cytoplasm is bounded by the plasma membrane and contains many organelles in eukaryotic cell. What do you mean by eukaryotic cell? If nucleus is covered with the membrane called nuclear membrane, it means if nucleus is covered with nuclear membrane, then such cells are called as eukaryotic cell. If nucleus is naked, it means there is no boundary around the nucleus, then such type of cells are called as prokaryotic cells. In eukaryotic cells, we can see many organelles. Next, cytosol. The cytosol, the aqueous part of the cytoplasm outside all of the organelles, also contains its own distinctive proteins. It consists of its protein, it accounts for almost 70% of the total cell volume. It accounts for almost 70% of the total cell volume. Gelatinous substance consisting mainly of cytoskeleton filaments, organic molecules, salt and water. The gelatinous substances contains filaments, organic molecules, salts and water. Chemically, the cytoplasmic matrix is composed of many chemical elements in the form of atoms, ions, and molecules. So, cytosol is the aqueous part of the cytoplasm. It measures almost 70% of the total cell volume. It consists of organic molecules, salt, water, in the form of atoms, ions, and molecules. Next, let us discuss about cell organelles. Following organelles are present in a cytoplasm. First one is mitochondria. Second one is endoplasmic reticulum. third lysosomes, fourth Golgi apparatus, fifth peroxisomes, sixth vacuole. Each organelle is bounded by a lipid membrane and has specific functions. All above six organelles are bounded by a lipid membrane and they have their own specific function. So let us discuss each organelles in detail. Already you studied in your lower classes, like in class 9th, you studied about plant cell and animal cell in detail, but here we are going to study each organelles in detail. Let us discuss about mitochondria. Mitochondria were first observed by a scientist Kolliker in 1850 as granular structures in the striated muscles. First he observed mitochondria in striated muscles in the form of granular structure. Mitochondria are called the powerhouse of the cell. Mitochondria is also called as powerhouse of the cell. This is the one more question for the NEET CET. Let us discuss the structure. It is filamentous or globular in shape. The diagram of mitochondria is important for the exam point of view. So please copy the diagram and learn the diagram which is there in the NCERT textbook. Components of the mitochondria are outer membrane, inner membrane, and intermediate space. Christe matrix. Total 5 components are present in the mitochondria. Let us discuss each component in detail. Intermediate space, it is a space between outer and inner membrane. Here you can see the all cell organelles. Inner membrane, outer membrane, Christe matrix, and space between inner membrane and outer membrane is called intermediate space. The membranes are made up of phospholipids and proteins. Membrane made up of phospholipids and proteins. Outermost membrane. It contains large number of integral membrane proteins are called as porins. These porins form channels that allow molecules of 5000 daltons or less to pass. Prions helps for the movement of molecules of size 5000 daltons or less. Outer membrane studded with enzymes concerned with biological oxidation. You studied about oxidation in chemistry. So it helps, enzymes present in outermost membrane helps for the biological oxidation. Next, interior or matrix of the mitochondria. The matrix of mitochondria contains enzymes concentrated with citric acid cycle and respiratory chain oxidation. About this citric acid cycle and respiratory chain oxidation, we are going to study in the next chapter. So here I am not going to explain about that. So matrix helps for the citric cycle and respiratory chain oxidation. Major metabolic pathways involves in oxidation of carbohydrates, lipids, and amino acids, and part of special biosynthetic pathways involving urea and hemisynthesis are located in inner matrix. So inner matrix perform its own function by helping for the metabolic activities like carbohydrates, lipids, amino acids, and some biosynthetic pathways or located in the inner matrix. So these are the functions of outermost membrane and interior matrix function. Next, inner membrane. It contains ATPase, it is the enzyme, and other enzymes concerned with synthesis and metabolism of ATP. So ATP, it consists of ATPase enzymes and some other enzymes which helps for the synthesis and metabolism of ATP. The full form of ATP is adenotriphosphate. It contains enzymes for electron transport chain. About electron transport chain also you are going to study in the coming chapter. So it contains enzymes which helps for the electron transport chain. The ultimate purpose of these mechanisms is oxidative phosphorylation and synthesis of ATP. So final idea or product is to prepare ATP. Mitochondria has some protein synthesized by mitochondrial DNA. So mitochondria prepares some type of proteins by the help of mitochondrial DNA. DNA helps for the synthesis of proteins. So first I told you the mitochondria is called as powerhouse of the cell, because you can see here in the second point, the ultimate purpose of all the mechanisms in mitochondria is to synthesis of ATP. ATP is the energy molecule. So mitochondria prepares ATP, it means it prepares energy molecule. So they called the mitochondria as powerhouse of the cell. It provides the energy in the form of ATP to perform activity of the cell. Let us discuss function of the mitochondria. First point, power generating units of the cell. Mitochondria are the power generating units of the cell, because as I told you, they synthesis ATP. ATP is the energy molecule, so it is also called as powerhouse of the cell. Second point, it is important to maintain proper concentration of calcium ions within the various compartments of the cell. As it prepares the ATP, it also helps to maintain the concentration of calcium ion in the various compartments of the cell. Third point, energy transduction through respiration. So the respiration, it takes the oxygen and it oxidates the food molecule, that is glucose, and it produces ATP, that is energy molecule. It is responsible for thermogenesis. Thermogenesis means generation or creating or preparing. Thermo means temperature. So it also helps for the maintaining proper body temperature. So this is the function of mitochondria, and mitochondria is one of the organelles present in the cell. So this much is enough in this video. Please go through the textbook, refer the diagram and learn the diagram of mitochondria. We'll meet in next video with some more components of the cell. Thank you.